Good morning, church. Welcome to Resurrection Lutheran Church, alive and online. Join us as we enjoy Alex's prelude. Wonderful. Thank you again. Good morning, church, and welcome to Resurrection Lutheran Church, alive and online. We are delighted that you have joined us from near and far, be it from across the street, across town, or across the country, or from around the world. And already we have folks checking in from Kentucky, Arizona, Pennsylvania, and Nebraska. We are honored that you have invited us into your home and into your lives. During the worship service, we will offer synchronous communion. So before we begin, you may wish to gather a few items, including a candle and matches, bread or cracker, and wine or juice. Participation in communion is optional. We come to you from our sanctuary here on Plank Road in Fredericksburg, Virginia. So let us know that you are here through the Facebook chat. Resurrection is a faith community reflecting the love of Christ through reaching to each other, loving God through our praise and worship, and for caring for all of God's children. The RLC faith community offers several opportunities to join us in mission. Many of RLC's reaching ministries are meeting through Zoom this week and offering exciting and unique learning opportunities. Join us for our monthly online coffee hour for fellowship. This time offers opportunity to talk with RLC's leadership team and to ask questions. We will meet via Zoom at 11 a.m. immediately following this worship service. Today at 3 p.m. here at the RLC campus, we'll have a drive-by goodbye for Joy Bushman, one of our charter members. She'll be moving to Texas this week to live near family. On behalf of the RLC faith community, we wish you Godspeed and farewell as you begin this new adventure. You are loved and will be missed. Holy Hops, join us for a fun time discussing relevant topics during our online theology pub. We will meet via Zoom at 7 p.m. this evening. Women's Bible Study is on Wednesday at 9:30 a.m., and we're starting a new book, I Want You to Be On the God of Love by Tomas Halik. This book considers the future of Western society with its strong division between Christian and secular traditions. On Thursday at 7 p.m., the Micah Study Group will finish their book study of Love is the Way, Holding On to Hope in Troubling Times. We will show our love for God through worship and praise as we gather in person this afternoon at 4 p.m., for physically distanced and fully masked worship. This coming Wednesday, our fifth and final Lenten Holden evening prayer with reflection and meditation will live stream at 6:30 p.m. Our theme is the call to I Am, and this week's reflection and meditation focuses on John 11, verse 25, I am the resurrection and the life. Our caring ministry, Faith in Action, along with Lutheran World Relief, is collecting items for personal care kits to be given to those who have experienced catastrophic events and natural disasters, both here in our nation and around the world. You can find out more about what is happening at RLC and details for all activities by reading the latest edition of the RLC Weekly Update. Links to these and many other opportunities to join us in mission and ministry in a meaningful way can be found on our website, resurrectionpeople.org, or the events section of the Resurrection Lutheran Facebook page. If you are on Facebook, be sure to like us to get notifications of upcoming activities and ministry opportunities. This Easter, you can remember or honor a loved one by donating an Easter lily or a pink or blue hydrangea for our Easter garden. You can access the order sheet on our website via the worship page, and the deadline for ordering is today. Join us in prayer by putting your prayer requests in the chat on Facebook. We ask that you submit them before the end of the sermon. In recent days, we have witnessed the horror of gun violence in Atlanta and the vandalism of one of our ELCA congregations, Grace Chinese Lutheran in Seattle. As a nation, we continue to witness and suffer from the cruelties of racial and gender-biased violence. We will join in solidarity with our Asian American and Pacific Islander siblings in prayer of lament and healing during the intercessory prayers later in this service. We continue our Lenten worship series, Rend Our Hearts, Claiming the Promise, with Written on the Heart. In the book of Jeremiah 31:33, we hear from God, "I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people." What is the law that Jeremiah tells us that God is wanting to write on our hearts? Well, it is a relationship. It is a law of love, and of loving, and of acting in loving ways toward all, stranger and neighbor and family. This is what is to be written on our hearts. Leading us in worship today are Allie Beck, Alex Johnson, Ann and Chuck Price, and Greg Williamson. Our video production team is Dave Evers, Robert Schull, and Kelly Slunt. And I'm Reverend Heidi Moore, pastor here at Resurrection. So as we begin worship, let us light our candles. We gather this day in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Join us as we sing the call to worship, Come As You Are. The words are on the screen and in the bulletin.
Of sadness forever you've been, come broken hearted and rescue begin. Come find your mercy, O sinner, come kneel. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Lay down your burden.
Join us for the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the keeper of the covenant, the source of steadfast love, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. God hears us when we cry and draws us close in Jesus Christ. Let us return to the one who is full of compassion. Fountain of living water, pour out your mercy over us. Our sin is heavy, and we long to be free. Rebuild what we have ruined, and mend what we have torn. Wash us in your cleansing flood. Make us alive in the Spirit to follow in the way of Jesus as healers and restorers of the world you love. Amen. Beloved, God's word never fails. The promise rests on grace. By the saving love of Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God, your sins are forgiven, and God remembers them no more. Journey in the way of Jesus. Amen. At this time, we invite you to share peace with your brothers and sisters in Christ for those across the nation or right there in the room that you are in. Be sure to email or give a text or phone call as you share the peace. The peace of the Lord be with you and also with you. Again, the peace of the Lord be with you
and also with you.
Join us as we sing Tree of Life and Awesome Mystery.
Tree of Life and Awesome Mystery. In your death we are reborn. Though you die in all of history, still you rise with every morn. Still you rise with every morn. We remember truth once spoken, love passed on through hands and words. Every person lost and broken wears the body of the Lord, wears the body of the Lord. Christ you lead and we shall follow, stumbling through our steps may be, one with you.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all
and also with you.
Together, let us pray. O God, with steadfast love you draw us to yourself, and in mercy you receive our prayers. Strengthen us to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit, that through life and death we may live in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Join us in singing and reading of Scripture.
according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, and blood of my transgressions, wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, my sin is ever before me, to you alone, against you I have sinned, done evil in your sight. You are justified, against me testified, I'm guilty since my birth. O Lord, open up my lips, my mouth declares your praise. You don't delight in sacrifice. If I gave birth offerings, you would not be pleased. The sacrifice you want is our hearts. You desire truth in my soul, so teach your wisdom to my heart.
Today's reading is from Jeremiah 31, verses 31 through 34. The days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the people of Israel and with the people of Judea. It will not be like the covenant I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to lead them out of Egypt, because they broke my covenant, though I was a husband to them, declares the Lord. This is the covenant I will make with the people of Israel after that time, declares the Lord. I will put my law in their minds and write it on their hearts. I will be their God, and they will be my people. No longer will they teach their neighbor or say to one another, "Know the Lord," because they will all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord, for I will forgive their wickedness and will remember their sins no more. The word of the Lord.
Let us welcome the gospel in song.
Nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God. Nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God.
Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit.
Nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God. Nothing in all creation can separate us from the love of God.
The Holy Gospel according to John, the 12th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. And they came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew, and then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor. Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I invite our kiddos to come forward. And I have trouble remembering things. And so quite often I'll take a Sharpie and I'll write it on my hand. And people will ask me, "What's that on your hand?" And I said, I'll just tell them it's a reminder. Because if I don't do this, then there are going to be things that are forgotten, or I might do them in the wrong order, or what have you. So I use this Sharpie, and I write it on my hand. And this said children's sermon, so I made sure that I got the children's sermon done. I had to remember. We heard in the book of Jeremiah this morning, when Nancy Siplicki read it, about a God who's going to remember our sin no more. We have a God who chooses to forget the things that we do, because, and he has written his love onto our heart as his law, because that's what he wants us to remember, is his love, and he chooses not to remember our sin at all. Amen. Written on our hearts, God does not want us to forget that God has chosen to forget. Jesus says to Jeremiah and to us, "But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people." See, this is a promise made with us. A law placed within us, written on our hearts. I will be their God. You shall be my people, says the Lord. See, God imagines for us a beautiful kingdom filled with love and peace and freedom. And these words of hope come to Jeremiah during the time in the life of Judah where it was anything but. Jeremiah, a Judean prophet, walked with his people through the 40 most tumultuous years in his country's history, a time to which we refer to as the Babylonian diaspora. called by God during this to be a prophet in the 13th year of the reign of King Josiah. And that's around 626 BC. He continued his ministry until after the siege and capture of Jerusalem by the Babylonians in 586 BC. Now, the book of Jeremiah, which records many of his oracles, reflects these turbulent times in four sections that contain prophecies against Judah and Jerusalem, narratives about Judah, prophecies against foreign nations, and a historical appendix. And this portion that we read this morning comes from what is called the Scroll of Comfort, which tells of the restoration of Israel and speaks of a change of heart, a new law that God has written, a new promise between God and the people with which God seeks desperately to be in relationship. But being the stiff-necked people that we are, isn't it just like us to push back on this beautiful vision of the kingdom of God? A vision that we so sorely need in this time of unrest and division in our own country. Do we not say to ourselves, and maybe even subconsciously without even realizing it, without even being aware of it, what's wrong with my heart? I don't need a new law with which to be governed. Or as I proclaimed often as a child to those seeking to tell me what to do, especially my older brother, you're not the boss of me, you can't tell me what to do. I've said many times, and I said it in this week, in fact, that I don't pick the scriptures each Sunday. I just preach them. They come from a guide called the Revised Common Lectionary. And sometimes the gospel, the good news, doesn't sound like very good news to me at all. And it might not sound like very good news to you either. And it just might be saying things to each of us that we just don't want to hear, like maybe we've gotten something wrong. And it is at these times the Holy Spirit reaches out through the Word of God and pinches really, really hard. And I can tell you it makes me really angry. It is at these times I must, and I encourage all of you to do the same, to take note and realize that in love, God is seeking us out, seeking our hearts to write a reminder upon them. God is not seeking to take away our freedoms, but rather to remind us that there are other ways of looking at things. And maybe, just maybe, the way I'm looking and way I'm thinking might be wrong. This idea of writing a new law, or more precisely, cutting a covenant, harkens back to the covenants that God made with God's people. Beginning back in Genesis, Abraham and God walked between the split bodies of sacrificial animals to seal the deal of Abraham being the father of many, more than sands on the beaches and more than stars in the sky. And the Ten Commandments, or the Ten Good Words, too, are a covenant inscribed upon stone by God and carried by Moses in Exodus. So Jeremiah takes these two things and merges them. So rather than walking through sacrificed animals, it is a living, breathing human being. And rather than stone, it's our very hearts, what was then considered to be the center of a human's will and intelligence. And so this new promise, this new covenant, is written upon our hearts. I will be your God, and you shall be my people. So rather than a law, it is a relationship. It is a reminder of the kind of relationship that God seeks with each and every one of us, his people. It is a law of love. It is a law of loving and acting in loving ways toward all, and all means all, be it stranger or neighbor or family. There are no exceptions. There is no wiggle room. And that is what makes the events of the past week and this year particularly heartbreaking, as we have witnessed increasing violence against Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders, who may be strangers, but their neighbor and family nonetheless. Surrendering our will to God, we have the freedom to love and to reflect that love to neighbor, family, or stranger, to be freed, to be who we truly are, children of God, and to act accordingly. Or put another way, surrendering to the will of God gives us the freedom to be who God has made us to be. And isn't that the paradox of the gospel? Isn't that the paradox that Jesus speaks about when he says, those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. So to find myself, I must lose myself. To be the one who leads, I must first serve. And just like the seed that must lose itself into the ground in order to become what it is intended to be, a fruit bearing plant. In these verses from John, we hear about the subversive irony of yet another crisis point in the history of Judah. Another time when countercultural thought and practice runs head on to the authority of the day. You see, they thought burying Jesus in the grave was the solution, but really, it was just planting a seed. Kill Jesus to ward off the wrath of the Roman authorities, and instead a new plant springs up. And Jesus, lifted up, draws all people to himself and bearing much fruit. Putting this text from John alongside that of Jeremiah begins to make sense, especially if we look at the cross in covenantal terms. A new promise cut from the wood of the cross. In all the covenants that God has cut with God's people, and we are God's people, is to know these covenants is to know God intimately and to live with God in love and relationship. And when God said to us through the mouth of the prophet Jeremiah that God will be known from the least of these to the greatest, Jesus too came to make the unseen God visible through the shape of God's love. And the shape of God looks like Jesus and loves like Jesus and gives like Jesus and includes like Jesus. The life, death, and resurrection of Jesus does make a difference in our lives. It is through reflecting the love of Jesus that we can become the covenantal community, the beloved community that reflects love, justice, and humility. May we be the community that God so much desires, the community in which truly reflects what God promised to Jeremiah, I will be their God and they shall be my people. In relationship with God, we are God's people with God's love written on our hearts. Amen.
Okay.
relying on the promises of God, we boldly pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You wash us through and through, and remember our sin no more. Make your church a community of forgiveness throughout the world. Give your people courage to forgive. Through them, show the world new possibilities. Bless ministries of repentance and reconciliation. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. O God of all, with wonderful diversity of languages and cultures, you created all people in your own image. Free us from prejudice and fear, that we may see your face in the faces of our Asian and Pacific Islander siblings and people around the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Heavenly Father, we grieve the mass shooting in Atlanta, Georgia, that took 8 lives, including 6 Asian women. Help us to be the beloved community that you created and desire, where all are valued and honored. Hear us, O God.
Mercy is great.
Hold our siblings of Grace Chinese Lutheran Church in Seattle that was targeted with a racist message scrawled across their driveway in your loving and caring hands as we hold them in our hearts. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. O God, our help and comfort, accompany our nation in this time of uncertainty and loss. As we grieve, assure us of your unfailing presence. As we seek direction in the days ahead, guide us by your wisdom. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You fill the earth from tiny grains of wheat to the mighty thunder with your presence, and you call us to attend to your will for all creation. Grant weather that prepares the soil for seeds. Protect all from violent storms, flooding, and wildfires. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You promise to write your law on our hearts. Guide citizens throughout the world to shape communities that reflect your justice and mercy and peace, and give them creativity to work for the welfare of all. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You sustain us with your bountiful spirit. Restore the joy of all who need to know your presence. Those who are lonely or feel unforgivable. Those who need healing of mind or body. Those who are dying and all who grieve. Especially we remember this day, Dot Falconer, Paul Clausen, Kathleen Beck, Bill Evans, Judy Thompson, Sue Perdue, Jordan Dominguez, Linda Marsak, Terry Evers, Nancy Downey, Ruth and Terry Harefield, Dot Falconer, Paul Clausen, and all those suffering from COVID. We ask that you keep Joy Bushman in your heart and in your hands as we wish her Godspeed and farewell. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Jesus calls us to follow him in life and death. Empower this congregation in discipleship. Equip children and teachers in Sunday school, confirmation, and learning ministries. Give us your truth and wisdom, and teach us to follow Jesus. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In the cross of Christ, your name is glorified. We praise you for those who have given us words to worship you. With all those who have died in Christ, bring us into everlasting life. And this, we especially remember lives lost in Atlanta this past week, the climbing numbers of those lost to COVID. Be with those families, Lord, and comfort them. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Again, we offer thanks and praise for your support of our mission and ministry here at Resurrection Lutheran Church. And yesterday, I'd like to hold up our property team who came to this campus and gussied us up for Easter. So I want to call them out: Fred Riedel, Matt Clausen, Steve Terry, Allison Terry, Tom Evans, Rich Trost, Ann Palmer, Tony Jenkins, Norm Saley, Alex Johnson, and Marcus Kramer, as they gave their talents and their times to keep us looking good. Again, thank you for your prayers and your support of our mission and ministry here at Resurrection Lutheran Church.
Thank you.
God, you walk beside us in desert places, and you meet us in our hunger with bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal, that we may pass over from death to life with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right. Give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. You call your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that, renewed in the gift of baptism, we may come to the fullness of your grace. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. He was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as our Savior taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus draws the whole world to himself. Come and be fed with this meal. This is Christ's table, and he spreads it out before us. He does not care how we come to this table, whether we are high in faith or low in faith, or wondering if we have any faith left at all. He simply bids us to come, because when Christ says all, he means all. Join us as we sing Lamb of God. Receive the body and blood of Christ where we are in our homes and as one, taking our bread, the body of Christ given for you. and with our wine. The blood of Christ shed for you. Amen. Let us pray. God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. At this time, as we sing our celebration hymn, we invite you to join in one of the traditions of our congregation during this time when we gather together. We would hold hands with each other and sing this. Now, I know that we're not together, and I know that you very well may be alone in your place. So if you are not, hold the hand to the person next to you, or just hold it up to the screen, and we'll do the same. Our celebration hymn. Receive the blessing. You are what God made you to be, created in Christ Jesus, freed to serve your neighbor. May God bless you, that you may be a blessing in the name of the Holy and life-giving Trinity. Amen. Amen. Join us as we sing Power of the Cross.
Once in darkness, now in light. Once blind, now you see. Once a sinner, now a saint, once bound, now free. As the power of the cross, see the chains fall. As the power of the cross, see the chains fall.
Power of the cross.
as we are sent out on mission this day to reflect the love of Christ by reaching out to each other, loving God through worship and praise and caring for all of God's people. Just a few reminders. Following this worship service, just as soon as we can get the Zoom call up, our monthly online coffee hour will be held via Zoom. In-person worship experience is offered at 4 p.m. today. Sign up on our website or Facebook page. At 3 p.m., be sure to come to the RLC campus for the drive-by goodbye and Godspeed and farewell to Joy Bushman. Holy Hops Theology Pub is tonight at 7 p.m. via Zoom, and it's BYOB. Remember that Easter flowers orders are due today. And this week on Wednesday, Women's Bible Study meets at 9:30 a.m. via Zoom. On Wednesday evening at 6:30 p.m., we live stream our final midweek Lenten Holden evening prayer service with meditation and reflection. Micah Study Group meets on Thursday at 7 p.m. Links to these and other ministry opportunities, as well as the flower sign-up, can be found on our website. Keep working on your World Relief personal care kits. And so links to these and all this can be found on our website, resurrectionpeople.org, or on our Facebook page. We'll see you here on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. and next Sunday at 10 a.m. Until then, beloved of God, go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God.
Chains, your chains.